My name's James Green. I'm a director at David's Werner.
How many artists are participating in your gallery?
In the gallery, in total, over 60. And we brought around 15 to the art fair this year.
Just tell me about this artwork. Who is the artist? What is the theme behind this?
So this is this whole room is by an artist called Marcel Zama, who's Canadian born, living in New York. And actually, he's come with us to the fair this year. Yes. First time one of our artists has come in person. Yes. So what you're seeing here is new work he created specially for the fair. And also this wall painting was done site specifically before the fair opened. So this is a piece created specially for the fair. What you see on the wall is directly on the wall there at the fair. So that was a special mural just for people who come to the fair will see.
How do you like this fair?
It's our third year here, and yeah, we hope to come back for many more years. It's been a very successful fair for us.
These all sculptures are based on the same theme that I did last year, but technically it has evolved in the more solid form. Previously I was doing in a transparent form with fine wires, but this time I've developed a unique style with the same material with a different technique that has evolved with a trial and error. The whole form is with the same thing with made of fine wires. I've included thick wires with a more solid form. The overall theme is the same, the growth and decay that we see in nature. And that is perpetual thing that is always going in nature, and the tree of life is my source of inspiration, that we associate our lives with the tree of life, and we observe our different stages of life in a tree form.
So how you molded these type wires in some furnace or something like?
No, this is directly fabricated in a direct process. Okay. One wire on another.
Okay. Yeah. What about this one?
These are all the same thing. Mm-hmm. And the form is different. Mm-hmm. It's you can see the transformation of transparent into more solidity.
Okay.
Yeah. So that was the you can see that previous fine wires. Mm-hmm. That has came up with the more solidity that started with there and transform into more solid and solid.
So this work is called The Unbearable Derangedness of Being. Okay. And it is about the entire sort of politics of consumption. So basically how in recent times what we eat and what we consume not just in terms of food, but the media and everything. How that has been scrutinized and sort of manipulated. That's what the work is about.
What is this called? But let's say wall installation or some...
It's a painting.
It's a painting.
Yeah.
What is this material?
It's paper.
Paper. Okay. So you are done here only?
No. I did it in my studio and it's installed here.
Okay,
it's
okay.
Actually... it's attached. I mean, it's the size is variable. So because of the wall here, it's installed.
Just
like
tell about this tone. Why you are choosing the white background and the white is?
So this is white on white because I wanted it to sort of almost merge with the wall and come across as seepage on the wall and become part of the installation. And only when you go very close, then you can sort of see the images. I wanted it to be almost camouflaged.
But this is a one message in whole composition?
That's the entire, so it is about, so it's all, it's personal, at the same time it's political, because in today's time, as you've seen, politics has sort of entered our daily lives. So okay. Where the lines between the political and the personal have started blurring is not very easy to know. So that's what the art has to reflect.
This booth is about gender, sexuality and equality and personally choice. It's a site of flux where we are changing the display according to the theme that we choose today's aesthetics of violence, plus gender, of course, wherein there is an installation here which is stop, and which is basically to tell people to stop objectifying women. We selected artists according to the theme as we set for every day, and we have performances happening every day according to the theme. So it's kind of interesting how audience are reacting to it in this art fair, which has not been happened too much. So it's interesting to also look how people respond to it. I've been a part of this curatorial team, and Maina has curated this booth. It's extremely, extremely heartwarming to see how people welcome it and how everybody is so curious to start new conversations.
So how many artists participating in this show?
So in this booth we have about 30 artists, and we also have some performing artists, including all of it. There are about 35 artists here.
Why it is called Aks?
So this is an Iranian artist. His name is Arman Stepanian. He chose Aks because it's a digital print. It's a photograph, yes. It's a photograph. And he chose this as a comment on what's going on in Iran, mm-hmm. and to literally comment on the present situation and how women are treated there.
These are all photographic printouts, like?
It's a multidisciplinary booth. We have performances, we have photographs, we have fine art print, we have oil on canvas, we have acrylic on canvas, everything, watercolor, miniature artwork. So something like this work is by Puneet Kaushik, and he's a very good artist. He's worked with beads on canvas, and this is like a blood splatter, which is aesthetics of violence. Something like this is a drawing by Satyakam Sahu, and this is like a landscape, which is an aerial view of a landscape with an abstraction to it. This is Gopa Trivedi. She's a miniature artist, and she's the name of this work is Foreign Objects. This is to comment on citizenship and how immigration and everything is happening in today's world. Nothing is original from your own country. All these vegetables and fruit have been acquired by other countries. They are not originally from India. So she's just making a comment on it. This is a work by an Italian artist. Her name is Marta Roberti, and she again marks the point of female body, how they react to nature and feminism. Something very interesting here.
Very, yes.
This is something very interesting here.
Close. What is hand is signifying?
So this is basically a closet, as you can see, and it's like open the hands, and you see a lot of artworks here. These are all LGBTQ artists, and they are trying to get out of closet. So this is like a metaphor on the society.
My name is Burkhard Riemschneider. I'm one of the owners of the gallery. We are existing since 25 years, and it's our second time to be at Art India. We brought a kind of like, after having been here last year and getting a very good feedback from people who really appreciate the artists we're bringing, which they all knew about, or a lot of people knew about, but never had seen work into the flesh, so to speak. We this year decided for a quite ambitious installation. In the center we have an installation by Olaf Eliasson, which is a work which in a way activates the audience. It's all about seeing yourself seeing. I mean, if you stand in the center point of the work, you see yourself reflected in reverse in the crystal spheres. If you go to the right, the piece turns yellow, and if you go to the left, the piece turns black. And it's kind of the idea what we also like following here in the booth. We try.
What is called? Is it installation or is some sculpture? What do you think?
It's called a wall installation.
Wall installation?
Yes, yeah.
Okay, please come.
And you can see how it activates the people. I mean, it's probably the most Instagram and most photographs work on the whole art fair, because in a way, what Olaf was doing, he's kind of activates the people. Without the audience, the work is nothing. And you can see that. I mean, everybody finds his own kind of approach, finds himself in the work while the work is looking at the audience, while the audience is looking at the work, and then it changes its kind of outcome from the angle you look at it.
Nature Mort has been in existence for the past 20 years.
Okay.
The promoter, Peter Nagy, actually started the contemporary art scene in the country. He moved from New York and he started the Nature Mort Gallery in Delhi.
Okay.
And Aprajita Jain, who's the other promoter, joined him 5 years ago.
Okay.
And since then, there's been no turning back.
Mm-hmm.
We think we're one of the best contemporary art galleries in the country.
Oh.
We have 30 artists in our roster. We manage 30 artists, and some of them are, like you can see over here, Bharti Kher.
Okay. So they're all Indian artists?
We do South Asian, Indian and South Asian artists.
Okay.
So like you can see Bharti Kher's work over here.
Okay.
She is she works with female bodies and deconstruction and reconstruction.
Mm-hmm.
So basically her concept is that she likes to deconstruct things and then reconstruct them with her vision.
Okay.
And she uses a medium in her work, as you can see in all her works, would be Bindi. which is the national symbol for Indian women here. Okay. So if you can see the work behind the lady, that is entirely made with bindis.
Okay, I know. What about this? This is something.
So this is another artist of ours. This is another artist of ours. The name is Tanya Goyal.
Okay.
So basically, she works with debris and stones of buildings that have been demolished and that have been are under construction. Mm-hmm. So, and these works are called frescoes. Mm-hmm. So she gives them her own shape and her own vision, and then she paints on the top of it.
That is done by her.
That is done by Tanya Goyal. Yes.
Okay. Okay.
अरे सबसे बढ़िया बहुत अच्छा है जो मतलब ऐसे लगता है ना कला का कुंभ है कि सब आर्टिस्ट साथ में के एक्चुअली बहुत जरूरी है पहले तो कि मिलना जुलना हो जाता है फिर उसके बाद वैरायटी ऑफ और यंग आर्टिस्ट को बहुत चांस दिया आपने और इतना अच्छा एटमॉस्फेयर क्रिएट किया कि पूरा आनंद ही आनंद है और इंटरनेशनल सेक्शन अलग है नेशनल वाले हम लोग को अलग है और जो ज़्यादातर मैंने इस बार देखा है कि जो धींग धकड़ा चल रहा था ना वो थोड़ा कम हुआ और जो रियल चीज़ को आपने प्रेजेंट किया बहुत अच्छी बात है और ये होना चाहिए और बार बार
आप इतने बड़े म्यूजियम मतलब आर्ट गैलरी के आर्ट डायरेक्टर हैं डायरेक्टर जनरल हैं तो क्या गवर्नमेंट या आप सब मिल करके इस तरह का शो गवर्नमेंट नहीं करना चाहती है
नहीं गवर्नमेंट करेगा अभी प्लान हम लोग कर रहे हैं और प्राइवेट का साथ मिलके हम करेंगे कल नहीं अभी जैसे वेनिस बिनाल किए हैं वो मिलके हम किए हैं तो आगे भी हम ऐसे भी प्लान कर रहे हैं हम मिलके करेंगे सॉरी
हम लोग धूमिमल गैलरी के स्टॉल पे खड़े हैं और इस बार हम लोगों ने प्रोग्रेसिव आर्टिस्ट ग्रुप जो है उन पे फोकस किया है और ख़ास तौर से KHRA पे फोकस किया है उनके 10 काम लगाए हैं जिसमें से स्टिल लाइफ भी हैं थोड़े से न्यूड्स भी हैं और साथ में हुसैन साहब का भी पेंटिंग है FN सूजा का है कृष्ण खन्ना का है शक्ति बर्मन का है तो जैसे मैंने बोला इस बार हमने KHRA पे काफ़ी फोकस किया है तो जैसे सूजा राजा हुसैन 3 प्रोग्रेसेस है जिन पे लोगों ने काफ़ी फोकस करा है बट KHRA और HA गाडे 2 ऐसे हैं जिन पे इतना अभी फोकस नहीं आया है तो इसलिए हम लोगों ने इस बार उन पे ख़ास तौर से फोकस करा है
तो इस बार का आर्ट फेयर आपको कैसा लग रहा है
इस बार आर्ट फेयर में एनर्जी तो अच्छी है हर बार की तरह बट धीरे धीरे मुझे लग रहा है कि मॉडर्न का स्टॉक कम हो रहा है लोगों के पास तो सिर्फ 4 से 5 स्टॉल हैं जहाँ पर आपको मॉडर्न देखने को मिलेंगे बाकी जगह मोस्टली फिर कंटेम्प्रेरी चीज़ें देखने को मिल रही हैं तो वो एक चेंज मुझे लग रहा है कि धीरे धीरे अब
और सेलिंग रिस्पॉन्स कैसा है इस बार
इस बार मेरे हिसाब से जो बायर्स है वो मिड वैल्यू के लिए ज़्यादा हैं 2 to 5 लाख वाले क्लाइंट ज़्यादा हैं जो जो ज़्यादा एक्सपेंसिव चीज़ें हैं जो 30-40 लाख एंड अबव की चीज़ें हैं उसका रिस्पॉन्स इतना अभी नहीं है एज अपोज टू प्रीवियस ईयर्स जहाँ पर थोड़े मेजर वर्क्स भी अच्छे प्राइस पे निकल रहे थे
इस तरह से इस देश में बहुत एक्टिविटी अच्छी हो रही है मैं 2 साल से इस तरह का आयोजन मैं खुद अटेंड कर रहा हूँ और बहुत इंस्पायरिंग थिंग है देश दुनिया अपने देश में आके आज आर्ट फॉर्म एंजॉय कर रही है और हमारे आर्टिस्ट के साथ डिस्प्ले हो रही है राष्ट्रीय ललित कला एकेडमी के नाते इतना कहना चाहूँगा कि आने वाला त्रैवार्षिक भारत देश आर्टिस्ट हमने बुलाया है उनके डेटा जमा हो गए हैं हम चाहते हैं कि इसी तरह से और इससे भी बेहतर ललित कला एकेडमी परफॉर्म्स करे
माय नेम इज़ मधु कुमार आई एम अ कनेडियन आर्टिस्ट ओरिजिनली तो इंडिया से हूँ बट आई एम इन कनाडा नाउ एंड आई एम प्रैक्टिसिंग आर्ट नाउ तो मैं फर्स्ट टाइम आई हूँ यहाँ पे इंडिया आर्ट फेयर में और बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है देख के मे बी नेक्स्ट टाइम आई वुड लाइक टू पार्टिसिपेट हियर
तो जैसे कनाडा में इस तरह के आर्ट फेयर होते होंगे तो आपको क्या कंपैरिजन नज़र आ रहा है कि यहाँ के आर्ट फेयर में कनाडा के आर्ट फेयर में कैसा रहे
मैंने कोई खास ऐसे आर्ट फेयर नहीं देखे हैं
अच्छा
हाँ पर दिस इज माई फर्स्ट एक्सपीरियंस विच इज़ वेरी गुड
Chaube, I run a studio space called Art Bar Studios, which is in Okhla, New Delhi. It's a co-working space for artists. I usually come to India Art Fair every year, and this time is as fabulous as ever. Saw a lot of really, really good works, but one work which made my day was the Ai Weiwei, which is at a gallery in the second hall. So really like.